Hey, what's going on, folks? This is Dimitri back again, and in this video we're gonna review tour of Bruce Willis' private island and mansion there. It cost $37 million, actually $37.5 million, and so let's get started.
House is nicely set back from the street level. Gates open up to your sandy driveway, palm lined, beautiful landscaping, and this is a really private setting. House is situated on a 7.37 acre lot, super private, and the same driveway brings you to this point where we have the covered entry. Also, driveway splits up and takes you to each one of the homes that we have on the property, including the owner's suite. And coming to this side, we have the covered entry. This is the main home. Beautiful beachfront estate. I love the hardwood clad on the exterior, palm trees, house blends in beautifully with the landscaping around. And coming to this covered entry, we have the steps taking us to the wraparound deck, and we have the front door here. Let's go inside. Off of the entry, on the left-hand side, we have the staircase going up to the top floor. Right here, we have this door opening up to a powder room for the common spaces here. And as we go through this opening, we go straight into the great room. This is a phenomenal space facing the Atlantic Ocean and your backyard. Sliding glass doors open up. You have your dining area here, seating area on this side. Just a beautiful space. Now, before we continue our tour, I want to give a little bit of information about this property. We have 12 bedrooms, 14 full, one half bathroom, approximately 17,000 square feet of space under the roof, 7.37 acre lot. You have 1,100 feet of beach frontage and currently on the market for $37.5 million. And I want to give big thanks to the house manager, Mike, and the listing agents, Nina Siegenthaler and Joe Zam, for putting this trip together, making this tour possible. I'm so excited to be here. And as always, you can find more information about this property in the description of this video. Now, this is an amazing space. And around the corner, we have the main kitchen. In fact, I want to take you guys that way. It starts here. I like the light and bright color palette, shaker cabinetry, and this is an awesome kitchen. Opens up to the outdoors, to the wraparound deck. We have the commercial fridge here, island in the center, sink around the corner, gas stove, beautiful space that opens up to your great room. Go back to the main space, seating area right in front of us, facing the incredible views. We have this space seamlessly opening up to the outdoors, views of your backyard and the Atlantic Ocean. It looks incredible. And around the corner, we have our outdoor dining area. And in a bit, we're gonna have our lunch. By the way, they've been taking care of us so well ever since we came to the island. And yeah, soon we're gonna share our lunch with you guys. Coming back to the space, I love these pressure treated wood floors with dark stain, contrasting nicely against these white walls. Definitely has that island beachy feel to it. And on this floor, we have two spacious guest suites. First one starts right here. King size bed, French doors opening up to the outdoors, wood clad walls, nice and warm. And around the corner, we have a full bathroom with a glazed tiles on the back, vanity set up with quartz countertops and a spacious walk-in shower. Now, I'm gonna skip the second guest suite, which is right across the room because they're totally identical to each other. The only difference is they have different color back tile design. That way they have their own identity. But yeah, we have two guest suites on this level facing the backyard. Now, we have this door opening up to the screening room. Love the seating setup here, looks super cozy. Door opens up to the wraparound deck, TV here, nice cozy room. And if you want, you can put the shades down and black out the space, which makes it perfect for screening. Now, let's go back to the great room, and around the corner, we have the staircase taking us to the top floor. This floor is designed for the kids. Super cool space. And I want to talk about this door here that takes you to the covered entry where we have the portico. I mentioned this space off of the exterior, and you get amazing views of the property. Cool space that connects you to the wraparound balcony. Now, we have a small table here for the kids, and this space takes you to the seating area on the top floor. It's all open, sliding glass doors, takes us to the wraparound balcony where we can see the backyard and the amazing views of the ocean, vaulted ceilings, cozy seating setup. I love those two ceiling mount swing chairs. And around the corner, we have the TV with the sound bar, just a cozy hangout area. We even have a table here. Now, I'm gonna start with the first bunk room that we have on this level. We have two in total. it starts here. This one has more of the lighter tones, built-in seating here with some drawers on the bottom. French doors open up to the balcony, and it's just a cozy space dedicated to the kids. Each one of the beds gets their own reading light. It's super cool, and I would love to be a kid here.
Yeah, this whole house, this is like a dream scenario for a child. You're
absolutely
on this incredible beach. You have, yeah, I mean, obviously, it's really cool.
It's so cool, right?
Yeah.
And around the corner, we have this small room that could be turned into a bedroom, or you can put more bunk beds here. And this door opening up to the full bathroom. Vanity design here with a long vessel sink, two chrome fixtures, perfect for the kids. Around the corner, we have a separate water closet, and we have two walk-in showers here, chrome fixtures. Definitely a great bathroom that complements the bunk room. Now, I wanna take everybody back to the landing. Second floor of this property used to be Bruce Willis's primary bedroom suite. When the current owners took ownership, they converted the space to kids' play area and bunk rooms, and that's why we have two bunk rooms here. But yeah, this used to be Bruce Willis's primary bedroom suite.
Well, I can see why it was his primary bedroom suite. He gets incredible views of the ocean, and the current owners, instead of staying here, they moved to the very edge of the property and took over an entire house, which we're gonna see a little bit, and that's now the owner's suite.
Correct, yeah. We'll see that in a bit. But yeah, awesome space, and this is actually where we have the second bunk room. Has a little bit of a different color palette, but it's pretty much a replica of the other bunk room that we toured. So in total, you get about six bunk beds here. Now, sliding glass doors open up to the wraparound balcony, and look at these views. Your landscaping looks spectacular. Palm trees, hedging. You can actually see the other detached structures from here, walkways taking you to the different parts of the home. It's pretty awesome, and I can actually hear our team and the chef getting ready for the lunch. Let's go downstairs and check them out.
Wow, guys, wow, that's a lot of in this house. Obviously, fantastic house, yo. This is not even an exaggeration. So, like, the views, terrific. Interesting layout, sort of like really okay, I can see that. So this is another one. So I think when we did another video about the I think it's in, was in Ohio or somewhere else, so it's it was a off-grid property and stuff like that. So it looks, the layout is very, very similar to this one. So I really like the setup here and the driveway here. This is really, really up to standard here, like up to like mortar court and stuff. So this is good. Yeah, so entryway kitchen. I like the wooden floors, like he said, like I like the lightning. It's a very wooden, entry, very wooden entry. So there's a lot of that. Great white space here, I like that. You can bring a lot of stuff through it. What I really note, I mean, the color scheme is not really crazy going, so it's very laid back. I think here, so you see if it's a, it's very, so like just in general, and based on like as I've been in the real estate business a little bit, so it's very a white color in the color scheme of the house just in general. So if you for example like look throughout the properties, it's just in general, you may notice some of the properties stay dominant, like white, a lot of white, a lot of dominance of the white color. And you can see here as well, so a lot of dominance in the white, a lot of like, basically, you know what, forget it, we're just gonna paint white, call it a day, this type of situation. So, and I feel like this is what it happened here. I feel like there might have been a different color scheme here, could have been, don't know, don't quote me on that, but possibility is there. Anyway, good wooden floors, but yeah, sometimes where I see like, hey, white color everywhere, basically white color tone of the walls, white color tone of the ceiling, meaning that they want to give much more meaning to, or like much more like feels a lot of space. So that's pretty much what the white does. A lot of people do that, but just that, I don't know why I went there, but just in general, if you guys wanted to know it, so there's that. A lot of interesting feature I noticed is that AC is not central. They have different AC units throughout the house, like different areas. You can see that singular unit for the location. So for example, here, that one, and another over there in the main room. So I like the kitchen is good. It's pretty, nothing fancy, but it feels nice and neat. Everywhere white again. Look at, so like white scheme everywhere. I think, well, it's probably a different color a little bit, but kind of offset the tone. But overall, look at like chrome gas stove there, everything like that went out, everything. So yeah, I mean, there is not a lot of things going on here. I mean, I like this walkway, a lot of wood, a lot of good stuff. So I mean, I like the, I like wood just in general, like how the floors look like, everything. But it's just the white scheme of things, it's a lot, just white, right? I don't know. So they are talking about this one. So back to this, a lot of white again, everything is white, everything nice and neat, good furniture, good that. Yeah, it's a lot of white, really a lot of white. I like that they actually, the reason I did at the beginning, that they I like that they did the entryway here, that the utility room for the guest utility room, it's, oh, not utility, the guest bathroom. Oh my god, they did it nicely, nice in style. And this bathroom here is very nice because, yeah, I mean, it looks nice, look at that. So they offset the tone, like, and this is what I like, perfect, because they kind of setting the tone with a little bit more ceramic. They didn't go too much like outside the box, but that, yeah, it's there. A lot of white again, white, you know, it's a lot of white. And then there's that gray door. So I mean, the house is good, don't get me wrong, but as I was going through like my real estate journey, and I will share with you, I actually gonna, there are a couple videos out to do a house hunting, because I'm prepping a couple of things, and but yeah, I will do a house hunt series, how I do like for hunting real estate deal. So that would be awesome. So I think, and yeah, stay tuned, like and subscribe, so that would be nice. But yeah, so a lot of white going on in this house, in this living room as well. I like the sound as well, sound system here, at least, well, they offset the color scheme, like whiteness, with the picture here. But yeah, so far there's a lot of light, guys, so let's continue, I guess.
Welcome to the backyard. Now this part of the home is really special. We have this zero edge pool here facing the breathtaking views. It's so inviting and landscaping looks great. And throughout the backyard, we have decking that connects each one of the homes. And it's just a great feature because this is a beachfront property and you can access the beach from different areas. And each one of the access points actually has an outdoor shower with a foot wash. That way you can enjoy the beach, come in, wash yourself or wash your feet and stay clean on deck. And it's pretty awesome. We have the kids pool around the corner, four pools in total. And right here we have the first detached casita. Now this is a one bedroom house with an awesome bathroom and an outdoor shower, but we're gonna tour the one on the other side because they're exactly same, the way it's designed, the layout, how it opens up to the outdoors. And like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, there are 12 bedrooms in this house, a lot of bedrooms. So I'm trying to skip some of them to make this tour a little bit shorter. Now, this detached casita has the same hardwood exterior cladding, sliding glass doors, open up to the bedroom itself, and off of the entry, you have a small seating section here, and then it goes into your bedroom. King-size bed right in the center, vaulted ceilings, ton of natural light coming in. Again, I love the contrast between dark floors and lighter walls, and I also like this shallow wall design that sets the bed a little bit forward, and it allows this walkway to take us to the walk-in closet, outdoors, or over here, it takes us to the bathroom. Beautiful custom cabinetry, two sinks, quartz countertops, oversized subway tile, and we have the toilet set up here, beautiful walk-in shower, freestanding tub, and more importantly, we have this outdoor shower here. We're gonna see a lot more of these outdoor showers throughout the home, and you have three shower heads, handheld, body sprays, chrome fixtures, and it's just great. It allows you to benefit from the outdoors. Now, I wanna take you guys back to the backyard so we can continue our tour on this side. Now, this walkway takes us to the owner's suite. It's another detached guest home that the current owners converted into a very special owner's suite where we have the primary bedroom, few guest bedrooms, and some common areas. Now, like I mentioned earlier, decking system here is great. That walkway actually takes you to the entrance of the owner's suite. Landscaping looks beautiful. They have banana trees, papaya trees, coconut trees throughout the property. And on top of that, it was formerly owned by Bruce Willis. I mean, how cool is that? He bought the land around 2000s, then he spent 4 years developing the home, and he lived in it for 15 years. And around 2019, he sold the home. And we're so honored to be here and touring this amazing property.
Yeah, you know, when I was a kid, Bruce Willis, I think, was my favorite actor. So this is around the time I was growing up when he bought this house. This is like around when The Sixth Sense came out, The Fifth Element was out, and I grew up on Bruce Willis. So
he's my dad's favorite actor.
Yeah, I never thought that I would be walking around this property, you know? It's incredible.
It's incredible, and apparently he was really involved in the development process of this home. He was staying in a tent around 2000s, watching the construction phase. I mean,
he could have stayed in a hotel, but he chose to sleep on the beach in a tent because he cared that much about the property and he wanted to be involved in the development process.
Absolutely, he even got married here, and we were told that this house is very near and dear to him, and again, we feel so honored to be here.
Yeah, definitely.
Amazing. Now, let's talk about the owner's suite. It's another house on its own, comes with its own pool. So this is our third pool here. Decking looks great. Sliding glass doors open up to the outdoors, and around the corner, walkway takes you to the volleyball court. And that volleyball court is actually situated right behind the peninsula, which we'll see later. Now, I wanna take everybody this way. We have the covered section here in front of these rooms and sliding glass doors. Outdoor dining area here, and we go straight into the great room. Seating area, dining area on the back. It's just a great spot for you to sit down, relax, enjoy the scenery. Vaulted ceilings, two AC units, and I really like the mood lighting that they have where the walls meet the ceiling. It just cozies up the space, and this owner's suite has two bedrooms, kitchen, and office. Office starts here, nice open space, sliding glass doors. Vaulted ceilings are also here. Wood paneled walls, and we have the desk right in the center facing the views. This is a great office. Think about it.
Yeah, you just get these straight shot ocean views right in front. If you get bored, you can just go out and go for a little swim.
And then go dip in your pool.
I guess not bored, but maybe you need some creative inspiration.
There you go. It's an amazing space. Around the corner, we have a spacious bathroom with a walk-in closet and an outdoor shower, which is great, which means you can also use this room as another primary bedroom suite. Now, coming back to the great room, on our left-hand side, we have the kitchen. This kitchen is great. Same shaker cabinetry, island in the center, sink. I love that this wall is all glass, including the exterior door, fridge, washer and dryer. Nice and convenient. And each one of these guest structures has a kitchen. Awesome. Now we are at the main entry. This is where we have the covered roof design. And we talked about this at the beginning of this video. Sandy driveway connects each one of the properties, each one of the homes on site, and it brings you to this point. Now, we have a full bathroom here around the corner, beautiful finishes, coarse countertops, vanity design. And coming back here, we have another guest suite, nice and spacious, comes with a full bathroom. And lastly, we have this door taking us to the primary bedroom suite. Obviously, it's facing towards the views. We have another one of these shallow wall designs, which creates this walkway that takes us to the full bathroom. Space looks great, sliding glass doors open up, hardwood floors. It's just awesome. Now, let's go check out the bathroom. It starts here, walk-in closet, vanity design on my left-hand side, quartz countertops. I love the glazed tile design that they have on the back, wall sconces, your toilet, freestanding tub, another one of these outdoor showers that connects to the side of the property. Then we have the walk-in shower here, subway tiles, chrome fixtures, rain head above, beautiful bathroom. Now, I wanna take you guys back to the bedroom so we can go outside. Now, this is a phenomenal owner's suite, connects to the outdoors, and I just love how unique of an offering this home is. Think about it, you have multiple structures, you have over 7.3 acres, 1,100 feet of beach frontage. It's just amazing, and then you just walk out to the beach just like that. Now, there's a gazebo here, and we've been told that this is one of the owner's favorite spots on this property, and it's not hard to understand why. I mean, look at this place. It's where you lay down, relax, enjoy the beach. In fact, I want to take my shoes off right now because we're going to take you guys out to the beach. I know, Mikey, you've been enjoying this property for the last few days. What do you think of the beach?
It's beautiful. I have to leave my shoes on, unfortunately, though.
For a little bit more comfort?
Yeah, we're gonna be doing some walking.
All right, guys, let's check out this beach. I mean, look how beautiful this place is. 1,123 feet of beach frontage, and water looks incredible. Sand is like powder. Around the corner, we have a peninsula, which is located on the northern side. Rock formation, landscaping, watercolor. I mean, this is breathtaking.
What's that water temperature like?
It's super warm right now, I'm going in. And we have two jet skis, by the way, and you just have them right by your beach. Whenever you want to have someone, put the keys in, you're ready to go. Mikey, can we turn this way? Look how beautiful this property is. I love the palm trees, you have lounging chairs, and the way they maintain this home. Every corner is impeccable. Then you wake up, come to your beach, go for a swim, go back in, go jump in your pool, have your breakfast. I mean, this is like having your own private resort. And this coat is just so beautiful. Honestly, I don't want to go back to LA.
Man, look at this. Oh my God. Oh my God. What a house, dudes. What a house. Wow. So, the backstory. Wow, this is good. So, swimming pool, obviously top notch. Nothing crazy. Love the patio. Love the whole thing. Maximum. Okay. It's pretty deep. Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah, well maintained, fantastic, gorgeous house, great. Obviously great. So another suite here. So I like the lights here. Very good, very nice touch. I think they changed the color as well over like just switching between like an hour every now and then. A lot of white. I thought actually that was interesting. So I haven't thought about like I've been expected a little bit different. There is a lot of white, a lot of white. I was wondering if it's actually like if the Bruce Willis kind of situation was there, and he selected a lot of white, or someone else has did that. So I mean nothing wrong with that, but there's just a personal thing. Being around the block a little bit with the real estate, that it's like you cannot really go wrong with the white. Like a lot of places, you just like, you know, if you don't know what to cut, like what to paint it with, go white. it's not white, it's like light white creamy, it looks like, but it's again like those kind of color schemes that's like you don't really go wrong with that. But I don't know, it's just I think like I feel like I wanted something extra. Like, I mean, for $37 million, $37.5 million, I think like I expected something more, I think. Like more architectural, like designy, I guess. I don't know, but like, it looks simple. Oh, I like the safe there, that's good. Oh, right there. But yeah, so detached, everything singular. So I like the house. I mean, this is gorgeous. I mean, outside, like this is another cool thingy that I noticed. I'm not sure what I feel about this stance here. Yeah, I mean, yeah, those poles is a little bit in the way. It's kind of like, yeah, it's kind of weird. But anyway, it's cool. Very much. I mean, relaxed, cozy place, beach resort place, your own really. Detached guest house. I mean, I don't see any difference there. Same thing. Yeah, it looks like it's a lot of lots of whites, lots of sort of like beachy vibe kind of setup. Yeah, it's old, man. Yeah, now yo, I can see it now. Wow. As soon as I mentioned, yes, this is so in there. Like the walls saying about it, like the style here, architectural design here. This is the roof though. It's a little bit. Sets it off a little bit. Oh, not the roof, the ceiling here. But overall is so so it's a lot of coziness on terms of beach style property. A lot of it, so yeah, I can see, like, it's throughout the house, like throughout those properties. This is great. Shower outside, like the doors, pretty good, really good. I mean, something to talk about, a lot of stuff. So, wow. Yeah, I mean, that's a good house, yo. Good house. Desk view. This is fantastic. Oh, yeah, this is very good. This is very good. Yeah. Look at that. Actually, oh wow. The white inside in this space, it's very good. It's very good right there. It's very good. Yeah. The white color scheme is good. The yellow right there is better. This is better. I think it's better. Anyway, so let's do a test video. All right, guys. So that's the house where the Bruce Willis lived. Yo, this is great. So right from the bed, fantastic house. Obviously, a lot of beach wipe, a lot of goodness going on. Another good thing to point out is one level. It's one level house, and you don't need to go like a lot of with the staircases and everything. So it's big huge plus. I love it. So another great thing is a lot of space. You can walk around, a lot of light, a lot of goodness just throughout the house. I mean, gorgeous views. I mean, come on, you cannot be like Sandy Beach and like the ocean looking views. Come on, like even like not even views, just like go ahead, like from the office, go ahead first. Come on, you cannot beat that. But anyway, obviously, lots of also there are drawbacks. Yeah. For $37 million, they can be just the price alone can be a drawback. So for a lot of people, another drawback, I feel like I wasn't sure about the neighborhood itself, meaning the just access to stores, access to just food, access to things like, you know, basics. So that was interesting too. Just thought about, like, I just need to do a little bit of research before, like, even if we purchase or whatever, but nonetheless, so that would be a concern. Another concern would be, I don't know. So, but yeah, nonetheless, so this is primary, pretty much primary. A lot of like the color scheme is a little bit off for me. A lot of white. I mean, a lot of white. Because, like, for example, I came in this house that I'm living right now, and even this wall right here, so it was more like towards white color instead of like towards dark. So if you guys can see that, like, it's a little bit more different tone right now. But throughout the house, it had like a lot of white. So, and for $37 million, I kind of like, we can do a little bit better than that. So, you know, like things like that. So, but overall, it was top notch. Everything. I like the Subway style, the kitchen backsplash. I think backsplash was too. But yeah, the tiles over on the walls for in bathrooms and other places, that was good. I like the tile work on the bathroom outside. Oh, the shower outside, that was good. But yeah, overall, it's pretty much good. So, drum sound and the big plus. So, overall, so the big question, no price tag, would I live there? Maybe. Yeah, I need to check. I would have checked about the stores and other locations, so things like that, where to go, how to go, and things of the overall. But it sounds like there's just 13 people on the island living there, so there's not a lot going on really. So you need to go and take a boat and go towards the civilization if you want to, like, I need to. So that's a drawback. That's probably going to be a lot of the deciding factor for me not to live there. That's pretty much that. Is it cozy? Yes, it's a lot of good. And like I said, there's a very huge beach vibe going on. So as you can see throughout the video, and you can see, like, if you want to roll the back for sure. But throughout the house, you can see the relaxness, whatever you want to call it. So the cozy vibe going on the beach. So you can see Coffee tables. You can see like the walls, like, you know, those wooden plank walls. And even though it's colored white, but anyway, that's another topic. But overall, house is great. But I feel like it's been repainted, but I don't know. Like, the paint looks very fresh, so it feels like it's been repainted. And I feel like it's been repainted because of, like, they didn't want to, you know, too much headache with the paint, how to go and like architectural design stuff. But if very much, like, I feel like the home is, that home begs like a lot of, like, it needs a different, like, color scheme. It feels like it needs more, you know, like, for that house, and more relaxed scheme, you know. So overall, yeah, overall it's good. Coziness level, yeah, it's pretty great. I like that there is no stairways and everything like that. So yeah, overall is good. Overall is good. Color scheme just that, but overall is good. I didn't see any electrical novelties like a solar roof or anything like that. For me, it's a big house, and that will take a lot of energy because there is a gas stove there. I noticed that. So they use gas and electric. Wasn't sure about the water here or there, but hey, that's something to consider. But if that is not like redundant in terms of like battery generator and things like that, big storm, electrical is out, bam, you're out. So hopefully they got generators going on, so hopefully that is in there. But yeah, overall, if that is not there, man, I think I would pass in that house for just in general, because it needs to have that because of those conditions. So yeah, overall thumbs up to the house. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. My name is Dimitri. If you like it, thumbs right on that button, destroy it. Well, don't destroy your phone or whatever device you're using, but yeah, like the video, subscribe, and see you guys next time. I hope you guys enjoyed it. So let me know in the comments below if you want to see something extra content or whatever. Always down to hear your guys' ideas. And yeah, so see you guys later. Bye bye.